Welcome to PhD Study Tips. Here I have some questions about postdoc. Some of the subscribers like Subame and Shane, as they're asking some questions about postdoc. These are the questions. What to do after postdoc? So what to do after postdoc? You have options to become a professor, to go for assistant professor, or become a lecturer and be in the educational field. That's what most of them are doing right now, so that you will have a good salary and experience, research experience, or else the second option is, after postdoc you can set up your own lab, do one important project, recruit some. You need to have some money to do this, but that may not be possible for many. The third option is like go to industry, okay, like as a researcher. So any industries, there are many industries out there seeking for researcher scientists. But unfortunately, most of them are recruiting, even PhDs for that sake. No need of postdocs for researcher scientists. For that reason, even M.Tech graduates or PhD graduates are being recruited. But postdoc, maybe they may not. Nowadays, postdoc means people think they are narrow-minded and they need to offer more salary for them. So though you have a good qualification, but opportunities are very less. The second question asked again by one of the subscribers, is there any course after postdoc? Is there any course after postdoc? First of all, postdoc is not a course. Okay. It is a research position. It is not a course. What do you mean by course? Course means something you do in the university. And there must be a convocation. Somebody must arrange a convocation and give you a degree, patta we call it, or the main certificate we call it. But for postdoc, it's nothing like that. So postdoc is, first of all, not a course. So this question is okay, you must know, so that there is no point of this question at all. The third question, is postdoc highest degree in the world? Is postdoc highest degree in the world? Again, I am telling, postdoc is not a degree. Okay, it is just only a kind of research experience or a kind of academic qualification, but not a degree. So, which means you must understand, PhD is the only degree and it is the highest degree. Okay, so is postdoc highest degree means yes. Postdoc is not highest degree. PhD is the highest degree. There is no highest degree more than PhD. But some people say that there is a doctor of literature, doctor of science to be the highest degrees, but still they are all doctors. So which means PhD is the highest degree as of now with convocation. That's very, very important for a thing to be said as a degree. Next question, difference between PhD and postdoc. The main difference is PhD is, it is the highest degree you study in a university, is a study-based, research-based PhD. But whereas postdoc is not related to any university, it is a project-based. In postdoc, you don't have a particular tenure, you don't have particular salary, you don't have particular project. Like there may be different types of projects, different type of tenure periods, so different types of temporary or permanent or contract. So there's nothing, there's no regulations for postdoc. It's just a research position, that's all. So the direct answer, difference between PhD and postdoc is, PhD is a degree, it is a qualification from the university. Postdoc is just a research position. PhD is for 3 years or 4 years or more than that. Next question, average salary for postdoc. What should be the average salary for postdoc? It is different in different countries. So it may vary. In India, you will have only 35,000 to 65,000. Or things may change every year sometimes, depending upon the norms of the university. But whereas if you go to USA, so USA postdocs, anywhere abroad, you will have good salaries. Like as far as my research is concerned, like there is a minimum wage set up by U.S. Fair Labor Standard Act. So this U.S. Fair Labor Standard Act tells that a minimum wage for postdocs should be $23,660. But as of now, you will get more than that per year, I'm speaking. So you will get anywhere around the minimum to minimum as per the act, $23,660 to $1,00,000 for postdoc salary per year. So that is about USA. Whereas if you take Germany, in Germany we have like E13 and E14 kind of levels. So E14 is the highest level for if you go for postdoc. Like you will get there in the form of euros. In Germany, like you will get around 3,891 euros to 5,570 euros. So this is the range of per year salary. Okay, for example, if postdoc is in Germany, and if it is in UK, you will have £37,553 per academic year. £37,553. Remember, pounds, euros, US dollars. So they are different currency. Then in Canada, you will have $50,000 per year for postdoc salary. $50,000. If you go to Middle East, like Abu Dhabi, Dubai, so you will get around per month. Let me speak this per month. $9,797 AED. So these are some of the salaries per year, but sometimes they may change as years go by and rules change by. So that is half. Today I would like to give one important information, because here most of my subscribers are asking, what is the highest degree? Is there any course after postdoc? What to do after postdoc and all? So basically I want to throw some light. What can you do the best thing after postdoc? See, there is one qualification after postdoc, after PhD. Let us leave postdoc from here. After PhD, there is one course you can do. So that is, if you want to get a full-time professorships, this is very much mandatory in many European countries, like in Europe means Poland, Switzerland, Germany, and France, all these countries, Sweden, all these countries, after PhD, if you can do habilitation, okay, habilitation, this is the name of the qualification. So habilitation means what? Habilitation means you will write additional thesis. In PhD, you are writing one thesis, no? So you will write an additional thesis that is called habilitation. If you have this habilitation, only you are eligible for professorship. You are eligible for professorship. Otherwise, you are not eligible for becoming a professor in Europe. A full-time professorship, that's the highest one. So doing PhD is not enough in these countries. So this habilitation, which means you will write additional thesis besides what you exactly write in your PhD thesis, okay? So the same thing is called different, with different names in other countries, like let me speak about Spain. Spain, we call it acreditación. Accreditation means this is also a prerequisite for full-time professorship. Nothing but this habilitation only, but different name, accreditation. A-C-C-R-E-D-I-T-A-C-I-O-N. Next, in Brazil, it is called Livre Docencia. L-I-V-R-E-D-O-C-E-N-C-I-A. So you can see here, I don't know whether you can see it ulta or normal letters. So anyhow, this is what we call, if you can write additional this and do additional research, that's where you are eligible for full-time research. So I hope I have written all these questions from my subscribers, and I hope I have given enough information. If you want any information regarding postdoc, you can just ask me comment below. Thank you so much and have a nice time.